Good day guys, Isar here from Cosa MTB, and today we're gonna be doing a bike check video. Nandito tayo ngayon sa Paradise, sa San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. What a beautiful view. Alright guys, so today ang bike na i-check natin is no other than, of course, yung nag-iisang bike ko, which is yung Dabam Tora Bora. So I've been using this bike for almost 3 to 4 years now. Binuo tong bike na to because I want it to be as a all-rounder bike. So pang bike sa loob ng village, pang morning exercise, or kahit pamalengke. And syempre, of course, pag mag-trail, it was really built for trail. And of course, kahit sa long rides. So I think it was 2016 when I first encountered yung Tora Bora na frame. And then sa website may nakita akong Tora Bora na naka free ride or all mountain setup. So yun yung ginawa kong basehan or yung pinagkopyahan ko sa pag-build ng bike na to. Okay, so guys, dito tayo sa frame. So ang Tora Bora Dabam frame has 3 versions. So cross country, yung pangalawa is yung bike edition. And then, ito nga yung sa akin is yung dirt edition. So, yung cross-country na frame, it was built talaga for a cross-country. Medyo iba yung geometry nung frame na yon. But itong Tora Bora bike edition and dirt edition, I believe it was purposely created for slope styles or jumps, and even sa free ride or kahit sa trail pwede rin naman siya. So this is a Tora Bora dirt edition, small size and 26er. So this frame, it can really take the beatings of the trail. Napakatibay, napakasolido. And this is what I love about the frame, no? Yung graphics niya. And meron siyang revolver dyan. So Tora Bora Dirt Edition. Eh, may nakalagay dyan. Dirt. Alright, so let's start all the way down to the top. So Minion DHF 2.30 from Maxxis. So I'm not really a big fan guys of tire combination, so I just decided na back and front is both Minion DHF. So Minion DHF, napaka ideal siya when it comes to trails, napaka kapit, napaka grippy. So it is tubeless ready na siya. All right, so rims naman, we're using a jet set rims, I believe it is inner width niya is 25 millimeter. Jet set. So ang jet set is napakatibay na rings. If you are into free ride or trailings, jet set is the way to go. So jet set HC downs, napakatibay, pambaragan. Yun nga lang, medyo mabigat siya, pero it's really stiff. And for the hubs, we're using Shimano non-series hubs. So if you want na pambaragan or matibay na hubs, Shimano non-series is the way to go. I've been using this hubs for almost 3 to 4 years now, and napakatibay. Once ko pa lang siya napaparipa and walang alog, walang sira. And for the rear brake, we're using Jore brakes. And for the rotors, I believe this is a 180 millimeter rotors SRAM. Okay guys, so for the front wheel, we're using the same tire, Minion DHF 2.30 from Maxxis. Same rim, jet set, HC down. And also Shimano hubs, non-series. And yung rotor is, I believe, 180. And also sa brake, yung Jore or Jore pa rin. For the drivetrain, we're using Jore or Jore group set. So for the clutch or RD, we're using Jore or Jore with clutch. So yung clutch niya, let's turn it on. So RD Jore 10 speed cog, 10 speed chain. So ito yung Jore na RD na long cage. And dito naman sa crank, 175 mil crank. Jore din siya or Jore. So I put a bash guard on it. So this is a teka-teka setup, 10 by teka-teka setup. So dalawang chain lang yung nakalagay doon, original na plato from crank. Yung original na plato ng Jore crank. So yung dalawa lang na maliit nakalagay doon. Ang fork na nakabit dito is XCR, Santur XCR coil type or spring type. So ang common travel ng XCR is from 110 to 120, but this XCR pina-edit ko siya. So right now it is 140 millimeter, and so far wala naman siyang issue. Hindi naman siya nasisira. So I've been using this for almost 3 to 4 years now. 140 millimeter, wala naman siyang problema. Hindi ko siya pinang-jump. So pang trail lang talaga, and wala naman siyang issue. Santur XCR with 140 millimeter. Quick release. Alright, so guys, let's go dun sa cockpit. So we're using a Jor or Jore. I believe ang model niya is Jor M615. So we're using ang holy shit grips from the bomb. At para naman sa handlebar, the bomb Apache 750mm. And for the stem, it's ABR. I believe it's Jablo. Stem 50mm. And for the saddle, we're using, I believe this is a MOB generic. So, meron na tayong bagong saddle sa bahay. Hindi ko lang kinakabit. Panhihiyang lang. And for the pedal, we're using a knockoff or generic the bomb pedal. So far, wala naman siyang problema. Matibay naman siya. And guys, for almost 2 years, I've been thinking na i-upgrade yung fork neto to a higher end one. But napag-isip-isip ko, if I'm going to upgrade yung fork, then since that yung fork is straight tube and or straight, yeah, straight tube. And karamihan ng mga fork ngayon is tapered na. So I have decided na kung i-upgrade ko yung fork and then isasambay ko na rin yung frame. And napag-isip-isip din ako kung i-upgrade ko yung frame since that this is an old frame, a 26er frame, ba't di na lang ako mag 27.5. So who knows, malay natin next month or next next month baka meron na tayong bagong frame. So instead of upgrading this fork, then I'll just upgrade the whole frame, the frame together with the fork, or maybe the whole bike. Charing! So I've been using this bike for almost 4 years now. I'm using it kapag magbo-bike sa loob ng village, pag mag-exercise, morning spin, or kahit na mamamalengke lang ako, I've been using this. And especially sa trail, ginagamit ko to. And kahit sa long rides, though medyo mabigat nga lang siya, the frame is heavy, and of course yung wheel set or yung tire niya is really not very heavy, but makunat siyang ipedal because it's trail tire or a downhill tire, so makapal siya, 2.30, medyo makunat sa kalsada, but it's still, it is all-rounder bike. Nothing special on this bike. It's not a fancy bike, or it's really not a very expensive one. I'm very happy and I'm very satisfied for what I have on this bike, especially its components. And this bike has been serving its purpose for almost 3 to 4 years now. So yun lang naman yun guys eh. As long as your bike is serving its purpose, or as long as yung bike mo is napagsisilbihan ka, or nagagampanan niya yung dahilan kung bakit mo siya binuo, then that's it. You should be happy about that. And if there's an urge to upgrade some parts of it, or maybe the whole bike itself, then go ahead. If money is not an object, then push lang. Upgrade mo lang yung gusto mong i-upgrade sa bike mo. But if money is an object, then dapat hinay-hinay lang muna tayo doon. We should always remember that family first, Yung pag-upgrade sa bike, eh, andyan lang yan. Anytime, pwede natin i-upgrade yan. So, this is it guys for my bike check video for today. And once again, I'm Isar from Cosa MP. Leaving you, if life sucks, go ride your bike. Chill.